Dude, so I'm actually gonna have to push my fucking bike. You gotta be kidding me. Fuck this. I'm gonna have to push this thing. This is horrible. Stuff at least. I'm sweaty as hell. Oh my gosh. I'm wondering why it blew. My glasses might be inside here.
Whoa.
Adventure, right? That was not staged, by the way. That whole shebangle of me blowing a fuse was not staged. I wonder why I blew a fuse, though, by the way. Skyline. So you hit Skyline Boulevard, you go that way and you'll hit Alice's Restaurant and pretty much go all the way back home. That'd be a fun little trip to take that highway all the way home. The nice thing is we'll go and see this really popular surf spot called Mavericks. So Mavericks is known, it's a really big surf spot down here in Half Moon Bay, where they hold the surf contest, what's called the Mavericks Invitational, which I think they got a new nickname for it now, but it's just these enormous waves and these big wave riders come down and from all around the world and surf these big waves and see who's the best at this wave. Half Moon Bay, ladies and gentlemen. We are here, Half Moon Bay. There is a Half Moon Bay Brewing Company there. There is the bay, the infamous radio tower. Now let's see if I can actually make it home this time. I wonder what kind of bike that was to begin with. Pretty cool. Wildbills.com. That sounds familiar. Oh, lobster trap, check that out. No wonder why it was stinky around here. All the lobster traps. Dang, look at that thing right there. Check that thing out. That thing is cool looking. Off-roader. Yeah. Man, it stinks over here though. There's more lobster traps. Tons of them. Whoa, look at those. Lobster traps. This thing stinks. Any leftover lobsters in there? So here we are at Half Moon Bay, and this is where the Mavericks Surf Spot is. This is obviously not how they get to the Mavericks Surf Spot. What they'll do is they'll charter little boats to come out here and go out and take you out to the lineup. But supposedly this is where the area is that you used to be able to go up and check the surf spot out. Oh, stop, do not enter. Oh. Can't go up here. This is what it says. Warning, U.S. Air Force installation. Authorized vehicles only. Do not enter. So I am definitely not entering. I'm going to go ahead and turn around after we get this nice, beautiful view of Half Moon Bay right here. That's what it looks like here. Pretty cool. Quiet little town. So this is where I heard you can hike up to go see the surf spot. Obviously, you're allowed to hike up there and go up there. You just can't be ticketed and towed. Yeah. And you could hike there along the beach. So there's two different spots you can go around that big old bluff, which is towards the beach, or you go up that way, up where that person was walking. Well, I'm glad I made it all the way down here. Anytime you break down on the side of a freeway, it's always a little bit nerve-wracking because there's people that are just going really fast right next to you, and then some people that kind of lean into your lane because they're looking at you. And you know the golden rule is that whatever you're looking at is where you lean. So if I'm looking to the right, you'll notice that my bike starts leaning to the right. See that? If I look to the left, it just kind of naturally does that. It's not that the motorcycles do that, it's that your mind kind of takes, your arms start to turn a little bit with it. So I kind of want to go down one of these roads and go check out the ocean. Look at that. Lucky are you to have a pad right there. Cooking the shrimp right there. No way. I'm gonna go take a look at that. I think they're boiling lobster right there and in there. Boiling shrimp inside that thing right there. You can see it smoking. Fresh crab. Fresh market too. Ooh. I won't even hold your time to take off my helmet. That's fine. My friends know who I am. I appreciate your time. Yeah. I didn't even think I'd catch you.
Get,
nice, oh, sure.
Backdrop here.
Cool. Yeah, right on, man.
Cool. Thank you. Cool. So what happened? Did you, was it a surfing deal, or did you kind of just bust it doing something else? Oh, really? So are you still going out there and hitting the big waves and everything? How do you keep in shape for something like that?
Don't stop doing it.
Do you like, I've seen those guys where they hold the weights under the pool and they're like running across the bottom to hold their breath. Like your breath, it's obviously, it's something different holding your breath out there than like surfing like a regular coast, right? Break?
You just gotta practice holding your breath.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Teaching your mind to not trip out when you don't have air.
Yeah. That's wild.
Yeah.
That's really cool. So, oh man. All right, well, I'll let you go. Thank you for your time. I appreciate it. Yeah, you too. Thanks, Jeff. That's cool. I guess some of my friends back home are gonna trip out on that. That'll be cool. I mean, he still paddles out on the big waves. Still paddles out when it's huge, and I mean, my lungs, I don't even know if I can handle a paddle out like that. You know, he's just, you just feel, you feel like an out of shape loot, like, not, I don't know how to explain it. Just an inactive piece of blob next to a guy like that. Really nice guy though. I mean, he was totally down to take a photo and stop what he was doing, and I kind of felt bad because it was kind of like heat of the moment, last minute, but wow, what a nice guy. What a nice guy. I'm so happy that I got a chance to meet him. I mean, what a day. Bike breaks down and you meet Jeff Clark.
All right, so it did it again.
I'm sitting here on the side of the road and my fuse broke, so this is what I did to get home. I've got a little bolt here and I've got this metal thing here. I'm basically hot wiring my bike. Hopefully this won't affect it.